All right, we're going to show you how to disassemble an air handler. A lot of people want to know how to put a fan motor in them or take out a control board. And I'll show you how easy it is. We're going to do it real quick. You take the grounds off the coil. Let's flip it up so we can see it here. Make sure your grounds are off. And I'll show you the whole disassembly process really quick like. And got a zip tie on it. Cut the zip tie. Pull your sensor off the coil. Then on your control board, you got a cover. Pull the cover off. This is your motor harnessed. Pull your motor. And this is your louver motor here. Remove your louver motor. Top of your control board. You got one screw at the top. Some might have two. Pull. Pull that screw out. And the control board snaps off. That's your control board. Then what you got left is your fan motor here. And your coil. This is a smaller machine, 12,000 BTU. We're going to take one screw out of our coil that connects to our fan motor. And then on the other side of our coil, we have a screw over here. We're going to pull it out. This machine was still on the wall and I was trying to put a motor in, it might be a little difficult, but you can pull your coil up now. And if you maneuver your coil, let's get it just right here. If you maneuver your coil just right, you get it past your fan motor, and you would have access to your fan motor and blade up underneath, if you could see that. Your blade's up under there. So this would be on the wall, and you'd have full access to it. But if you just take the two connections off the back, pull the machine off the wall, you pull your whole coil off. I'm trying to do this in. Talk just like that. Your coil lifts off. That's all won't be damaged. Okay. And now you have full access to your motor. So the easiest way is to unhook your two connections in the back. Pump your outdoor unit down so you don't lose your freon. Take your two connections loose. Pressurize it back with nitrogen to make sure you don't have any leaks. And that's the easiest way. And just do it on the table. And you can see it'll take 5 minutes. And to get to the motor, take two screws off of here. And the bigger machines might be a little different. You might have three screws. And then there you go. Your motor and wheel. Take this wire off here. Motor and wheel pops out together. And if I wanted to take that loose on your wheel, you have a blade either missing here to get to your set screw, if you can see your set screw in there, or some actually have it on the outside of the wheel right here. So it depends on which motor you get, how big a machine it is. But you can do it with the coil on there. It just takes some manipulating. You got to be careful how to bend it, but just that fast. And we'll take this motor here off. This is your louver motor. And there you go. There's all your parts to your machine and nothing left. Don't take but a few minutes. You'll have the whole thing disassembled. If you ever get it so filthy that it needs to be cleaned, if you find one that's 5 years old, no maintenance, just pull it apart. take this outside, wash the whole thing down, put it back together, and in 20 minutes, you'll have a full service new clean machine again.